In this video, I'm gonna deep dive in the Pytest fixtures. I'm gonna show through different examples the main usage of the Pytest fixtures. I'm gonna explain the behavior of the fixtures. What is the conftest file for? How to run a fixture for every test automatically? How to use the fixtures to run a teardown or a cleanup code? What are the scopes of the fixtures? How to use the fixtures as factories? How to parameterize fixtures? And finally, some useful built-in fixtures. Before starting, make sure to subscribe to my channel. This is the best way I can know you support me and like my channel. Let's start by testing a simple method which computes the mean of a list of values. Let's now write down the method to test. But I know that I will use this list in other test methods. A solution could be the following. But with this solution, if I want to use this factory in many modules, I have to import it again and again. What if Pytest does it for me? Now I only need to add the method name as input parameter in my test. I used to create a conftest file to include all the fixtures. The goal of the fixtures is to be reusable across many tests. I can even add a conftest per module if I use the fixtures only in some modules. This avoids loading all the fixtures for tests which don't need it. Okay, but what if I need many fixtures? I want to test a method which returns me the percentile value of a list. Now I need the list of values and the percentile, two fixtures. And now the method to test. For every test with input parameters, Pytest will look in the fixtures which one has the same name. It will call it and put the return value in the test method. And if it's a fixture which needs another fixture? Of course, this is a very easy example, but I can change many fixtures this way. Pytest not only looks for the input parameters in the test methods, but also in the fixtures. When running a unit test, Pytest will figure out all the fixtures necessary, and it will call them in the adequate sequence. Let's go now with a more complex example. I have now a database connected to my application, and I want to add some values to the database in the fixture. I won't use a real database, but a list with some object values. Configuring the database will take some more time. Until now, I've used the fixture to build and return some data, but I have to think about the fixture as a setup for my test. This will be my fake database, as said, just a list. This is the object I will add to my database. Here is the fixture. Instead of returning the value, my fixture only appends values to the database. Calling the fixture in my unit test makes the database to have values. I don't care about the returned value. But what if I want those values in my database for every single unit test? Do I need to add the useless input parameter for all my unit tests? Autouse indicates that Pytest must call the fixture every time. I don't need anymore to add it to my unit tests. After setting data in my database, I must clean it when the test finishes. How to run some code after the test finishes in my fixture? The yield keyword allows me to stop the fixture here. Then Pytest runs the unit test. And when the unit test finishes, the fixture continues from this point. The upper part is the setup of the unit test, and the lower part is the teardown of the unit test. First, Pytest will figure out the order to call the fixtures. Each fixture will be called and run until the yield keyword, if present. Then the test is run. When the unit test finishes, correctly or not, Pytest takes the same fixtures but in the reverse order, and it runs the remaining code from the yield keyword until the end of each fixture. Okay, but I don't want to insert all the data in the database for every single test, because this takes a lot of time. What if I could define a fixture which runs once for all the tests? Adding a second test, I can see the print only once. If I remove the scope and run again, I see the print twice. The scope says when Pytest runs the fixtures. It can be once per test session, package, module, class or function. By default, Pytest runs the fixture once per function. Let's go now with more fun features. I've done the setup of the database in a fixture, but for some tests I want to create a single item, and for some other tests I want to create three items. instead of returning values, my fixture can return a method, a factory. With this factory, I build a custom item and add it to my database. I want now to test how a method sums up a list of values. I can see that the test ran 3 times with 3 different values. The parametrized values in the fixtures allows me to run the same test but with different values. What about the request parameter? I won't talk much about it, but this parameter is the introspection of the request and test function. What does that mean? That I can access the context of the test in the fixture. Pytest calls the fixture before the unit test, but with the request parameter, I have dynamically access to the values of the test function. As said, I won't talk much about that because it's more complex. Leave a comment if you want more information about that or another video. Let's finish with one last feature. In fact, Pytest already has some fixtures prepared, some built-in fixtures. The request is one of them. I will use another one, how to capture what I've written in the logs. I have two useful fixtures, capsys and caplog. With capsys, I read all that was printed in the console, both standard and error. And with caplog, I read all what was printed in the logs. There are more built-in fixtures in Pytest, but I won't talk about them. The main goal of the fixtures is to run some code before and after the unit tests. Then you have some extra features, as the parametrized fixtures and the built-in fixtures. Thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe to my channel, click on the like button, and see you soon. Bye!